Now we've got some very exciting tech news to tell you about. Yahoo is turning to a teenager to boost its mobile development. The Silicon Valley giant has snapped up 17-year-old Nick Dalasio's startup in a deal reportedly worth as much as $30 million. His app, called Sumly, delivers 400-character snapshots of news stories to iPhone users, and it has the backing of the likes of Ashton Kutcher, Stephen Fry, and Asia's richest man, Li Ka-shing. So let's talk to the founder himself. Nick Dalasio joins me now live from our London bureau. And congratulations, Nick, on this Yahoo acquisition. First of all, tell us, what does this mean to you?
Yeah, it's been a fascinating 18-month journey. And I'm really proud to see that our technology will now be integrated into one of these classic internet companies. And there's so much opportunity for what we can do here at Yahoo. And I'm really excited to kind of see what we can do in the future.
It's amazing. It's been only 18 months, and here you are being acquired by Yahoo. And you're also going to be working in Yahoo's London office while finishing up school. Are you going to work on Sumly and try to improve on it, or are you going to focus on other projects?
I'll be focusing on other projects kind of on the side, as well as completing my A-level exams. But I'm really going to be focusing on integrating summarization technology at the heart of Yahoo's mobile solution. These summaries that we provide make it a lot easier for users to consume content and information when they're on their mobile screen. And so it's really exciting to be working with Yahoo and Marissa Meyer on this.
Now, Nick, I read that you started writing code at the age of 12. Did you teach yourself, and are you going to just continue with this and try to develop more apps?
So I taught myself to program using books and some video tutorials. And in the long term, I would love to, you know, start another company one day if I'm fortunate enough to. But for the foreseeable future, I'm really excited about working with Yahoo to integrate our technology and also look at other opportunities in the mobile ecosystem.
Now, Marissa Meyer is certainly shaking things up at Yahoo since she's taken the helm of it just six, seven, 8 months ago. Now, she has said it's all about mobile now. Did you have direct conversations with her? And if so, what kinds of things did you talk about?
I was fortunate enough to have had a few conversations with Marissa. I mean, the main thing we were focusing on and the thing that really excites me and the reason why, you know, I want to join Yahoo is there's such scale and opportunity here. You know, Yahoo has hundreds of millions of people visiting their content every month. And so for a technology like ours, or indeed any others, it's such a big platform to leverage. And again, with the focus on mobile and beautiful design, I think there's a ton of consumers who are gonna love these products.
Now, Nick, I'm here based in Hong Kong, and everyone here in Hong Kong knows Li Ka-shing. And to our international viewers, he is Asia's richest man. Now, Li Ka-shing was one of your initial backers for Sumly. How did his involvement come about?
So I released a demo of the application when I was 15 years old, and it was called Trimit. And I've been told that the investors read about this on a few technology blogs. And it was actually featured by Apple as one of their apps of the week in the new and noteworthy section. So they just cold emailed me. And after a few conversations, they ended up flying out to London. And they invested $300,000 when I was 15 in 2011.
Wow, what a story. You've got a great story, a great future ahead. Nick, congratulations, and thanks again for joining us.
Thank you so much.
That's Nick Dalasio, the founder of Sumly. Now, the deal with Nick and Sumly may also hold some clues about Yahoo's direction under Marissa Meyer. CNN's Christine Romans joins us now live from our New York bureau. And Christine, Marissa Meyer has said she's going to bring innovation back to Yahoo. She says it's all about mobile now. So what does this move say about her mobile strategy?
Well, you know, we can glean a little bit from this, what he talked about, summarization technology to bring it to the mobile space. I mean, that shows where there's a keen interest from Marissa Meyer. And, you know, we know so far Marissa Meyer and her strategy has been acqui-hires, buying, you know, small companies, acquisitions so that she could get the technical and engineering talent from those places. So here's someone who is trying to define what it is that Yahoo does and make it relevant for the mobile world. So when you hear people talk about Yahoo, they they say, wow, the stock is up so much under Marissa Mayer. We like the direction she's taken the company in. But what is the strategy? There are a lot of rumors about the kinds of things that she might be interested in, the kinds of companies she might be in talks in, all kinds of different mobile-type companies, rumors of the like. But so far, we've just had about a year to try to get a sense of where this company is going under. When you look at the stock is up. Investors are saying they think after a kind of a disastrous run for Yahoo shareholders that she's going to have some sort of solution for them. Yahoo is reportedly in talks to buy a controlling stake in Daily Motion. That's dubbed the French YouTube. There's also Zynga, OpenTable, Yelp, Millennial Media, a whole bunch of other companies. You always hear about them perhaps being in talks with Yahoo. But Yahoo hasn't really said exactly what its acquisition strategy is. In fact, even on this company that you were just talking about, this Summerlee company, you know, they haven't really released how the terms of that and how that's going to fit into their overall strategy as well. So she is still playing it pretty close to the vest. Amazing, that kid is 15 and he had a big investor, one of the biggest investors in the world. And now, wow, he's really on the fast track, isn't he?
Yeah, no kidding. And just to make us feel a little bit older, Christine, he was born after Yahoo was founded. So, my goodness. Now, talking about the strategy and what exactly is the strategy for Yahoo, they haven't quite specified, and you know, maybe that's something they hold close to the vest. But certainly, Marissa Mayer has left her handprints so far. I mean, Yahoo has changed its homepage. They've sort of jazzed it up. She's also said no more telecommuting, ordering all the employees back to the office. So what do you think we can expect next? So what other kinds of companies could they acquire? You had mentioned some smaller companies.
Right.
But what do you think the bigger picture is?
Well, so far, all of the changes have been sort of these internal changes where it appears as though she's recalibrating the company from the inside. You know, this is a company that was, quite frankly, on the ropes, where successive CEOs have tried to figure out what is it that Yahoo does. It was a first mover in the space, but had it fallen behind, and how are you going to make it relevant again? Such an important brand name. But, you know, even people who cover the company couldn't quite figure out what it is that Yahoo stands for is doing again. So from the inside, you know, clamping down on telecommuting, getting her talent back in the workforce, buying some of these smaller companies so she can acquire some of this top talent, you know, giving people smartphones and, you know, changing kind of the work inside, making it more nimble and fresh inside. Now we have to look and see what she does on the outside to make this company more nimble, relevant, and fresh. And that's where this particular acquisition gives a bit of a hint into where she's going. Her strategy is mobile, making Yahoo relevant for mobile, easy and relevant for mobile. That's where this particular acquisition fits in.
Yeah, she's certainly shaking things up, that's for sure. Christine, thanks so much. Great to see you.
You're
that's
welcome.
Christine
I loved
Roman's
your
live.
Interview, Pauline. That kid, oh my gosh, amazing.
Yeah, he's got a bright future ahead of him, only 17 years old and studying for his A-levels. Oh.